Okay, so now I want to switch to this code that's going to do a post. And it's probably easier for me to start with this by showing you how the code works. So let me go back. Oops, turn that off. I got to go back. So I'm going to do, I won't click auto echo, I'll do auto post. Okay, so what I want to do is I want to make it so there's no submit value here. Let me click on network. Let me clear the screen. I'm going to be able to change this text, and when I move out of this field, it's going to trigger a post. Not normally I would have to hit a submit button, but this is and you see this all the time where things dynamically update. You just go change them, some new stuff, and then it's updated, and away we go. Okay, and so you'll also notice that I show a spinner. I have to navigate away and click elsewhere, but then it detects that the text has changed. It sends it, turns a spinner on, and then it takes a while for the thing to come back. Now, I've got this little code so that it takes a bit of time before it comes back, and so you actually see the spinner, right? So spinner, send it, receive the result, turn off the spinner. Okay, so let's take a look at how this code works. Okay, take a look at how the code works, how it achieves it. Okay, so this little auto echo guy, auto echo simply takes the post data and echoes it, and it sleeps for a second just so we can see the spinner. Okay, so then I have a form in the main thing, so auto echo is its own little guy. And then the auto post is a form, and it has input type equals text, with a name equals one, and the value is hello there, so that's the default value. And then I have an ID of spinner, an image tag with an ID of spinner that's hidden. So it's hidden by default. It's there in the HTML when that comes out. It's there in the HTML when it comes out, okay? So then what happens is, in the JavaScript, oops, come back. I have to show you this in the page. I'll go through this twice so you'll actually see it. So in the JavaScript, what we're going to do is we're going to look up $#target. And $#target is this form. So what we're saying is go find that form and register a change. Whenever a change happens, call my function passing in the event. And this function goes from here to here. That's all the function code that is like, it's kind of like an on change, but we're basically saying, you know, go use jQuery to find this thing, find the thing with an ID of target, and then register a change event. And when the change event fires, call my code. So if we kind of work through this code a little bit, the first thing it does is it prevents the default, which is, don't submit the form. Then we go using jQuery, go find the spinner and show it. So showing turns the display to on. Then we go grab the form, which is, that's the whole form tag. It's this whole thing right here, the whole form tag. And then we can actually query form.find, and that is a jQuery again. And this is a little thing that's a little tricky, but basically what it does is it grabs the value of the input tag with a form name of one. So go find the input tag with a name of one and then get me the value. So that string is exactly this. Now, when we're running, that means it's changed. Somebody changed the text and the browser noticed it, jQuery noticed it, and said, oh, this text has been changed, so I'm going to call you. So your code's going to run. So you'll notice that then we say sending post in the log, and then we have another jQuery call. But this time we just call the post method right within jQuery, and there's a couple of parameters. One is the URL to post to. This is coming from, it's We're in autopost.php. We're going to post to autoecho.php. And the next is an array or an object of key value pairs. And this val is a post key. And then text is the text that we pulled out of that form field. So we pulled it out of the form field. We're going to put it in a post and send it to autoecho.php. And then the third parameter, let me get this real clear. This is the first parameter is what to post to. This is the post data. And this, all the way down to here, is the function to call when the post returns. And when the post returns, it's going to call this function that we just built. And, actually, no, sorry. The function that's going to get called is this function right here. And when the data, so it's going to, in the background, it's going to post the data with val equals whatever that value is to echo.php, and then data is the response. So date, remember, it's a request response cycle. So we send post data in, we get a response back, and it's in this variable data at this point. So then I'm going to console log the data, and I'm going to take the result. And result is this empty div. So it's an empty div just to place a currently empty space, okay? And I am going to take the dollar quote result, pound sign result says look up a tag with an ID of result, then empty that tag, pull all the HTML out of it, and then append the thing I got back from the post response. Okay, and then I hide the spinner. And then there's one more thing, and that is then this $post returns an object, and I call the error method on that object that says, if there is an error on my post, call my function and do a window console.log of error. And then return false is like the suppression of the default behavior. Okay. So let me show you, again, in somewhat slow motion, what's going on here. Let me clear this. Got to clear that first. So let me clear the network and press refresh. Now I've got an HR. If you take a look at the view source on this one, I've got an HR before and after the result, and the result is this empty div. And so you see this right there. It's like there's nothing there. And that is currently a div with nothing in it. And we see our form. We've got name equals one. That's going to be where our value comes from. And then we've got this hidden spinner. And so as this cruises by, we have to put this code after this code, because otherwise, $pound sign target will not find anything. So you can't put this script above it. This form target must exist. And we're registering saying, go grab this thing. And anytime anything changes in that form, call our function. Here's the function that gets called. And the function that gets called just starts up in JavaScript, and the first thing it does is shows the spinner, then it looks up the form, right? Then it extracts the value right there. Then it logs the word sending post. Then it actually sends a post to the URL autoecho.php with a post value of val, the value that is in this text variable text, which we just retrieved right there, okay? And when the post comes back, we are going to log the data that is the response data. Data is the HTTP response from that post. We're going to log it. We're going to empty the result, which is this div. It starts out empty, but the second time and later, it'll actually have stuff in it. So we're going to empty it out. And then we're going to append the data that we got back from autoecho.php, and then we're going to hide the spinner. And if I take a quick look at All auto echo does is sleeps for a second and prints out you sent and then post sub val. That's the post variable value, VAL. Okay, that's all auto echo does. Okay? So, request response cycle, we got auto post, which is our HTML source. It loads jQuery because it's told to load jQuery in the head. And then it loads the spinner GIF, which is right there, but it's not shown. Okay, so then I make a change, hi there, Glenn, and then I move out and I click the button. It's gonna show the spinner, look up, hello, Glenn. Let me go into console log. It did it, so hang on. Hello, Sally. Okay. So as soon as I move out and click anywhere, I moved out and clicked it to show you the console, but now I'm seeing the console. So hello, Sally. I'm going to move out. It's going to show the spinner. It's going to do this in about a second. It's going to show the spinner. It's going to look up the string, hello there, Sally, by finding the form and then finding the input tag within the form and then extracting the input tag from the form. And then it's going to call a post to autoecho.php passing hello, Sally. Then I'm going to get the output. Oh, I did it. Okay, so this is the output. As soon as I move the cursor to show you something, then it does it. So it sent the post and came back, hello there, Sally. And if I look at the network, you can see autoecho.php and the request had form data of hello there, Sally. I mean, URL, it's really val equals hello there, Sally, right? Val equals hello there, Sally. And then the response is just this text, you sent hello there, Sally. And that is the code from autoecho.php. That comes back in that little function. Right here, that function right there. Okay, that function right there is the response at that point, okay? And that's why I can console log it, and I put it in the result, then I hide the spinner, and if there was an error. So let me just trigger an error just for yucks, okay? Let's see if I can trigger an error. If I edit autoecho.php and just call this like some bad function that's not gonna work, hopefully that will blow me up, and then I will be able to see in the console that little error guy working. So it'll trigger it as soon as I click outside. Yeah. Actually, no, it just returned it. So that error didn't trigger the right way. But here's an error that came back. And if you're doing stuff with jQuery and these dollar posts, you got to be careful. And it's really good that I logged the stuff that I got back as soon as I got it. Because, oh, that's pretty, I just made a mistake in my autoecho.php. I better fix that. Now, I happen to show it on my screen too, but it's always good to throw console logs in there when you're doing something as tricky as this. So now I'll shut that back to sleep. And and it works. Okay? So that is a race through sort of jQuery. jQuery itself is an infinitely rich set of things, the power that you can do. I'm not going to sort of explain it all to you because it's so well documented, okay? And so, this is just a start, but the concepts I put in this lecture are very important, so make sure you understand them all so that when you're reading jQuery documentation, you're always learning more, okay?